Hey everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the soleus muscle.
Here we can see the soleus muscle in isolation. It's a large and flat muscle located deep to the gastrocnemius muscle. Here you can see the gastrocnemius covering the surface of the soleus muscle. And the combination of the soleus and the gastrocnemius together is what you commonly hear referred to as the calf muscles. And the calf muscles join together via the calcaneal tendon, which you might also hear referred to as the Achilles tendon. I've highlighted that here in green. So the gastrocnemius comes down here and it connects into the calcaneal tendon, which comes down and then joins with the soleus muscle, and then they both connect onto the calcaneus, also known as the heel bone. Another thing to note about the calf muscle group is that the official anatomical term for the gastrocnemius and the soleus together is a triceps surae. And you might be wondering why it's got tri in the name when tri refers to three, but there's only two muscles, and that's because the gastrocnemius muscle has two heads. So you've got the medial head and the lateral head. And when combined with the head of the soleus muscle, that makes three. So that's why it's called triceps surae. Next, we can see the origin points highlighted here in red, and that's going to be on the head of the fibula, as well as the posterior surface of the fibula. It's also going to originate on the soleal line, which is a prominent ridge which runs down the tibia here, and it's also going to extend onto the medial border of the tibia as well. So next, you can see the insertion highlighted here in blue, and you'll remember that the soleus and the gastrocnemius both insert into the calcaneal tendon, also known as the Achilles tendon, and that this calcaneal tendon is what comes down and connects onto the calcaneus itself. So the soleus muscle is connecting onto the calcaneus as its insertion point, but it's only doing so via that calcaneal tendon.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Soleus muscles connecting onto the fibula and the tibia, coming down here, crossing over that ankle joint. So as it contracts, it's going to pull on the calcaneus here, and that's going to result in plantar flexion of the ankle joint. So when the ankle is flexed like that, that's dorsiflexion. When it extends, that's plantar flexion. So plantar flexion is going to be useful in things like walking, running, jumping, anything like that. Now one thing to bear in mind, although the soleus is working with the gastrocnemius muscle, the soleus doesn't cross the knee joint because it's originating right here. So as the gastrocnemius can assist in flexion of the knee, the soleus can't. Its only action is going to be that plantar flexion at the ankle joint. So if you found this video useful, you found it helpful, enjoyed it, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there, really helps out the channel. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. See you all next time.